Now I am going to represent working of loop. In general statement are executed in sequence. The first statement in a function is execute first, followed by the second and so on. There is maybe situation when you need to execute a block of the code several number of times. Programming language provide the various control structure that allow for more complicated execution path. A loop statement allows us to execute a statement or group of statement multiple times, and the following diagram illustrates the loop statement. Conditions: if condition is false, condition code; if condition is true, here the condition works. If condition is true, then loop is automatically created, and loop is work on until and when condition is not false. Python programming language provides the following type of loop handle the loop requirement. While loop repeat the statement or group of a statement while a given condition is true. It tests the condition before executing the loop body. For loop, execute a sequence of a statement multiple times and abbreviate the code that manage the loop variables. Nested loop, you can use one and more loop inside any other while. For or do while loop. Loop control statement kya hota hai? Loop control statement the change execution from its normal sequence when execution leave us scope. When execution from its normal sequence when execution leave us scope, all the automatic object that were created in that scope are destroyed. Python support the following control statement. Click the following link to check their details if you want to check it. There is a break statement, continue statement, pass statement. They terminate the loop statement and transfer the execution to the statement immediately following the loop. Cause the loop to skip the reminder of this body and immediate retest it conditions period of retrieving. Pass statement, the pass statement in the Python is used when a statement is required syntactically and but you don't not want to any command or code to execute. Number of date the for loop is a Python used to iterate over a sequence, list, tuple, string or other iterable object. Iterating over a sequence is called a traverse. Syntax for loop: for where in a sequence, body of for loop. In the variable that take the value of the item inside the sequence on the each iteration, loop continue until we reach the list item in the sequence and the body of the loop is separate from the rest of the code using indentations. There is a working of for loop. In examination, if you're asking the working of for loop and working of while loop, you just do one thing. You just create a flowchart of the while loop and for loop and explain this flowchart with example. An example, you have just select the anyone, list, sequence, item, anything. There is a flow diagram for each item sequence. If you print a 1 to 5 range, yeah, 1 to 10 range elements, so then you using the for loop. The last item reach, there is a body loop. If the last element is reached, then body loop is always doing the each and every when the each and every element is print on your screen, the loop is executing all the element, and the last element the loop is itself terminate because there is no element for true and condition is false. The Python for loop, the program to find the sum of all the number. If you want to the list the number, there is a number 6538429, and variables to store the sum is equal to 0. And iterate over the list of the value in the number is sum is equal to sum plus value 1. And print the sum is sum. So when you run the program, the about will be the sum is 48 because there is a numbers and sum is equal to 0 and sum is equal to sum plus variable. Variable in the sense you first initiate the values. Print the sum is sum. The range function, we can generate a sequence of number using the range functions. we want to generate the sequence of number using the range function, and we'll generate the number of 0 to 9 numbers. We can also define the start, stop and step size as start, stop and step size. But in default is a lazy instance of because it does not generate the every number that is contained when we create it. However, it is not a iterate since it is support in LAN and daytime operations. The function does not store all the values in memory. It would be insufficient. So it remembers the start, stop, step size and generate the next number of and go on. Therefore, this function is the output of all the items we can use the function's list. And the following example is clear this. Print the range value, range 10, print the list of range 10, print the list of range 2 and 10, and print the list of range of 223. There is triple quotes bracket because the multiple statement we want to run it. If we are going to the 10, it means we want to print the 0 to 10 element. And there is no limitations, there are no starting points, so by default it takes a 0 values. Because in range, there is a 0 values starting from the range up to 10. And if you list of range 10, then it means you want to the number of 0 to 10, all the number. The print the list and range 2, 8, it means you want to start the element is 2 and in the element of 8. And you want to print the 2 between the 2 and 8 numbers, between 2 and 8. It means you want to print the number between the 2 and 8. So is the output is 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and 8 is not print because you just create a limit. Limit in the sense ki last element and last element is 8. In between 2 to 8 element is always print. 2 is print because the initiating number is always print. And print the list range of 223 because you want to print the all the element between the 2 and all the element. You want to print the all the element between 2 and 20. And there is a 3 difference between the elements. So 2 plus 3 is 5, 5 plus 3 is 8, 8 plus 3 is 11, 11 plus 3 is 14, and 14 plus 3 is 17. So this type of list is generated. So we can use a range function in the for loop to iterate through the sequence of number. It can be combined with the LAN functions to iterate through the sequence using the indexing. Here is an example of the program to iterate the list of using the general pop, rock and jazz and iterate over the list of using index number. If for I is the range of length and print the I like general I. Then I like a pop, I like a rock and I like a jazz because I like word add on the all the three elements gen. For loop with else, for loop can have an optional else block as block. The else part is executed if the item is a sequence or used in a loop exhaust. And the break keyword can be used to the stop for a loop, and in such a case, the else part is ignored. Hence, a for loop is else part is run if no break occur. Here is example to insert this. The digit is 015 and for I in a digit and print I as the print number no item is left. When we run the program, that will be output like 015 because you give a range 0 to 5, you give a list here digit 0 to 5 and for I in a digit print I else no item is left and you want to the when the first line is false, the else part is also executed. So there is a two lines, the for and else. Here the for loop print the item for the list until the loop is exhausted. When the for loop is exhausted, it executes the block of code nulls and print the no item is left. This for else statement can be used with a break keyword to run the else block only when the break keyword was not executed. Let's take an example. Mark for the student, there is a list. There is not a list, I think there is a descender because there is a key and key values. Key is a James and value is 19, Julie is 35 and author is 77. For the student in black, if the student is equal to student name and print the mark of the student, break is the printer no entry with that name found. no entry with the name is found because the for loop is not executed, because if the student name is student name, print the marks of student. So there is not a student, there is only marks of student. So therefore, if the statement is false and as if the statement is print, now Python is while loop and working there. I'm going to talk about the what is Python while loop and working. Loop are used to programming to repeat the specific block of code in this article. So you will learn the create and while the loop of Python. What is while loop in Python? The while loop in Python used to iterate the over a block of code as long as the test expressions condition is true. When generally use this loop when we don't know the number of time iterate beforehand. The syntax of while loop is in Python is while test expression in body of while loop. In the while loop, the text expression is checked first, and the body of the loop is entered only if the test expression is evaluated is true. So after one iteration, the test expression is checked again, and this process is continue until the test expression is evaluated the false. So you mean we are checking the true and false values. After one iteration, we are just check the test expressions. If condition is true, we check the test expressions, and after that check we are the expression is false and true. In Python, the body of the while loop is determined through the iterations, and the body start with the iterations, and the first unit like mark of the int, and Python interpreter any non-zero values as true, none and zero are the interpreted as false. The working of while loop. Enter the while loop. Test expression means you just check expressions. After that, you check conditions. Test expressions. If condition is or expression is true, then body loop is executed. If condition is not true, the body loop is not executed, and you false. Then up exit the loop. I want to add a natural number program, and sum is equal to 1 plus 2 plus 3 plus 7, and to take an input from the user, and is equal to enter n numbers, and is equal to 10, initialize the sum and counter the sum is equal to 0 and I is equal to 1, while x is less than equal to n, sum is equal to sum plus I, and I is equal to I plus 1, update the counter and print the sum is what, there is a n is natural, there is n is denote the natural number, sum is equal to the variable we are putting is equal to 0, we are adding the values, I is equal to initialize the values, initial values, enter number 10 and then sum is 55. Your program returns the expression will true as long as per the counter variable I is less than or equal to n. So 10 in our program, we need to increase the value of the counter variable in the body of the loop. This is very important and mostly forgotten. The following in the do's as a result is an infinite loop, never ending the loop. Finally, the result is displayed. While loop with else and same with the for loop, while loop can also have an optional else block. The else print is executed if the condition is the while loop is evaluated in false. And the while loop can be terminated with the break statement. In such a case, the else part is ignored. Hence, a while loop is else part run if no break occurred and condition is false. There is an example. Counter is equal to 0 while counter is equal to less than 3. Print inside the loop and counter is equal to counter plus 1 as the print inside of loop. The counter is equal to 0 and counter plus 1 is equal to 3. So the else part is executed because the while loop is printed inside the loop, and also the else part is inside the loop. So the counter variable print the string inside the loop three times because we are giving the three times. When the condition is true, after the condition is false, the print else part is also print. तो सो इन आउटपुट वी आर सी दैट देर इज अ थ्री टाइम्स ऑफ इनसाइड अ लूप एंड वन इनसाइड द एल्स बिकॉज द एल्स पार्ट इज ऑल्सो एग्जीक्यूटेड एंड वाइल पार्ट इज ऑल्सो एग्जीक्यूटेड सो वी आर यूजिंग द एल्स वाइल विद एल्स Now the fourth iteration, the condition is while can become a false, hence the else part is executed. Python break and continue. In this article, you have to learn the use of break and continue statement to alert the flow loop. What is the use of break and continue in Python? The statement break and continue statement can alter the flow of the normal loops. Loop iteration over the block of the code until the test expression is false, but sometimes we wish to terminate the current iterations over the whole loop without checking the test expressions. The break and continue statement are used to in case. Firstly, I would like to explain the break statement. In break statement, it means generally we stop the loop on that conditions. If we are giving the conditions, the break statement terminate the loop containing control of the program flow of the statement immediately after the body of the loop. If the break statement inside the nested loop inside another loop, the break statement will terminate the innermost loop. Center is break and flow chart of the break. Enter the loop. Text expression of check. Break. आप condition full हो गया yes हो गया तो आप exit हो जाओगे. बाकी के आपके remaining element print नहीं होंगे. फॉल्स होगा तो भी आप एग्जिट हो जाओगे. वर्किंग ऑफ ब्रेक स्टेटमेंट इन फॉर लूप व्हाइल लूप इज शोन बिलो. इफ कोड इनसाइड फॉर द लूप इफ कंडीशन इज ब्रेक कोड इनसाइड फॉर द लूप व्हाइल टेस्ट एक्सप्रेशन इफ कंडीशन इज ब्रेक देयर इज अ वर्किंग एंड देयर इज एग्जांपल. इफ वेरिएबल इज वन ब्रेक प्रिंट वेरिएबल प्रिंट द इंट. It means the for variable in string. Variable is string, str string, and the value is int. It means ki we want to calculate the value is 1 and 2 and print the int values. We are using the output of the values and int and int. So in this program, we iterate through the sequence of which check the letter I and upon which is break from the loop, and hence we see all the output that all the letter of till I gets printed. After that, the loop is terminated. In continue statement is used to skip the rest of the code and inside the loop for the current iterations only, and loop does not terminate but continue with on which tax is the iteration. The centers of the continue, the centers of continue, the flow chart of continue, enter the loop and text expression for the loop and false and true, the continue and yes or no, the remaining body for the loop and exit the loop. Flow chart of the continue statement is there, and if you want to execute this type of loop function and using the this working chart and this workflow diagram. You just see that in your examination, if asking about the what is continue loop and what is break loop and how to use with the while and for loop, this and then you just write down this diagram and this explanations with example, you get full marks on that questions. The working of that continue statement in for and while loop is shown below. There is a string, str is a string, I तक सारी वैल्यू प्रिंट होंगे, ठीक है. I के बाद कंटिन्यू लगा दिया हम लोगों ने, इसका मतलब I को छोड़ के सारे वैल्यू प्रिंट होंगे. अगर ब्रेक लगाते हो तो I तक के सारे वैल्यू प्रिंट होते हैं. जैसे हमने देखा था इसमें सर एग्जांपल में ब्रेक वाले एग्जांपल में कि हमने जब I लगा दिया तो इसमें str और इंड प्रिंट होके आया था. क्यों? क्योंकि I ब्रेक का मतलब क्या होता है, उस पॉइंट पर जाके वैल्यू को ब्रेक कर देना. इसलिए आपको ये वैल्यू प्रिंट हो गया रहा था str और द एंड, ठीक है. कंटिन्यू करेंगे तो क्या हो जाएगा आपका, इसीलिए इसका फ्लो चार्ट है, देख लो एक बार इसको ध्यान से लिख लेना, कहीं याद कर लेना, क्योंकि वर्किंग पूछेगा तो आपको ये लिखना पड़ेगा. और उसका जब कंटिन्यू का यूज़ करोगे आप लोग तो कंटिन्यू में आप इसको दिखाओगे, ठीक है ना. कंटिन्यू में आप पूरा स्ट्रिंग आर छोड़ के बाकी सारे एलिमेंट प्रिंट हो जाएंगे और लास्ट में द एंड प्रिंट आएगा, ठीक है. This program is same as above example of expert. The break statement has been replaced with the continue and we continue with the loop of the if the string is I and not executing with the rest of the block. Hence, we see in our output that all the letters expected I get are printed.